accomplished award-winning Montreal playwright and actor Vittorio Rossi. Last year, he received an award, the Canadian Authors Association Literary Award for Drama, for his play, The Last Adam. Good evening, Mr. Rossi. How and when did you know you wanted to be a playwright or actor?
Well, I probably knew early on in grade school. I had this wonderful teacher named Mrs. Booker in grade three. And I remember that year she divided the class into groups of five or six students, and we would have to write these little plays and, you know, build the props and costumes, and then we'd perform them to the other groups. And I had a particularly shy group, and I remember just taking a lot of charge and, you know, say it more angry when you come in, you know, and that kind of silly direction, whatever. But it was theatrical, and I remember it was one of the early instances in my life where I felt comfortable in communicating to people, because otherwise I was fairly shy. But that was my earliest remembrance of something theatrical. It was in grade three. Wonderful teacher. Yeah.
And what was your first play? How did that?
The first play. First play I wrote was called. It was a one-act play called Little Blood Brother. Started writing that when I was in university at Concordia, somewhere around, I don't know, 84, I guess, I started writing it. So I got it done, first produced in 1986. Back then, they had this wonderful festival called the Quebec Drama Festival. It's too bad it's not around anymore, it's a shame. But I won the award for Best New Play, and sort of got me going a bit, you know, and started in the profession.
You also won an award for Backstreets.
Yeah, the same award the following year in the same festival for another one-act play, and that pretty much cemented the idea that the first one wasn't a fluke. And with Backstreets, I was then invited by Morris Podbury, who ran Centaur Theatre, to be a playwright in residence. And in fact, it was there that I've been a professional ever since, meaning I was able to quit my job at the Bay selling shoes, so.
And so the chain came right after that?
Or? Right after Backstreets. That was now in, 88, yeah.
88. And that did very well at the Centaur Theatre.
Yeah, did extremely well, yeah. We even went on to the National Arts Centre in Ottawa. It had a nice run there, but it was very, very well received. They brought lots of Italians into the seats, you know.
And how did you get the idea to write about the chain?
Well, you see, that was something I was thinking about even during university. I mean, I remember, I still have these notes, actually. I filed away somewhere. I would say, okay, note. Think of ideas for family drama. Mm-hmm. Literally, I would write like family drama. And I would think of situations, you know, the meddlesome cousin, the strong, intimidating older brother, the more sensitive younger brother, the conflict with the mother and the daughter and the whatever and the sons and the father and the sons, and mm-hmm. just sort of take notes. Then in 1982, that was the year Italy won the World Cup in soccer. I was like, oh man, it's just amazing, right? That was a beautiful team. Nobody gave it a chance. You know, the stronger teams, the ones that were predicted to win, you know, Germany, Brazil, Argentina, the defending champs at the time, said, no way, Italy. And all the experts said, of all the traditionally strong teams, Italy, they said, would not even make it through the first round. So when they won, it was a shock to a lot of people, you know, because they, you know. Now, the reason why I bring this up is that I got the title of the play from that. You see, Italy traditionally plays a defensive style of soccer, not like the Brazilians with the crafty offensive attack, you know. Italians were very, you know, defensive, you know. And that defensive network, that defensive system, was nicknamed traditionally the chain, you know, catena, catenaccio, you know. So that's what they, that's how they won, you know. They would score quick and then bam, just hold the fort, and it was hard to penetrate that system, you know. When I first heard it, it says, the chain, this way, I finally realized that it would be a nice title in terms of it working as a metaphor for what I was creating in the story. The idea that a strong defensive family that can actually turn it in on itself and expose problems we all have within the family confines, you know.
And you also recently translated Filomena, which is now playing at the Avon Theater for the Stratford Film Festival.
Well, it was scary at first. I've never translated anybody's plays, especially not a great play like Filomena from Eduardo de Filippo. So it was scary at first, but then I think after I translated the first act, it's written in three acts. After I got rid of the first act, I grew a lot of confidence. Mm-hmm. And so I just steamrolled through the rest, and it became a little easier as I went along. But it was a tricky thing. The play is not only written in Italian, it's written in the Neapolitan dialect. So it's phonetically, you know, so it's, and my accent of Italian is just a little north of Naples, so I understand it.
Mm-hmm. Can you give us an example?
Well, for instance, you know, let's say, you know, the main character, the father, the man of the house, Domenico, he would tell his servant, Alfredo, he would call him, he would say something like, Alfred, dammi una tazza di caffè, right? Now, that's very dialect. It's very, you know, because the proper way of saying that line would be, Alfredo, voglio una tazza di caffè. Mm-hmm. But here it becomes, Alfred, dammi una tazza di caffè, right? So it's literally written that way. Instead of saying una tazza di caffè, U-N-A, it's na, N-A, tazza di caffè, you know?
So when you say dammi una tazza di caffè, you're not saying give me a cup of coffee?
No, I try to find a way to do it, so it would be like, give me a cup of coffee. Because that, I mean, you know, something like that, instead of give, I would like a cup of coffee, or give me a cup of coffee, you know.
And what are you working on now? What is your next project?
My next project, I'm trying to design the ultimate bank that you can't break into.
Seriously.
Two things. First is a play, the other is a screenplay. The play is a very important play, probably. It's a play I actually been with, the subject matter I've been with for about 3 years now. I was offered about 3 years ago by a local producer to write a possible miniseries on this subject. Didn't work out. CBC just kept playing stupid games, and that was that. The subject matter, though, because so much research was amassed that I felt obliged, and I made myself a promise, one day I'm going to tell this story. And I thought, well, I have enough of a background as a playwright, let's start off as a play. Eventually it'll take care of itself as a possible movie, I hope. The subject matter is the internment of Italians during the war in Canada. You see, I remember when I was a kid, whenever letters would come, you know, a simple letter, where the municipal government's, whatever, is telling you, okay, the garbage is now going to be picked up on Tuesdays and Fridays, or let's say, okay? So way back in the 60s, my mother thought, I didn't know how to read French, let's say, right? So everyone would go to my uncle, because he knew how to, we lived in Belgium for 10 years, you know? So, oh, God, this says you're picking up garbage Tuesdays and Fridays. So you'd be like a lineup, everyone reading letters, English and French, to my uncle, because he knew how to read both languages. Could you imagine if he was taken away from the community? It would affect the entire Rossi family. They'd be lost. We don't know what to do. What do we do? Well, that's what the arrest did. They took their doctors, the teachers, people ran little businesses. It wasn't about going after the regular working man. That, they weren't dangerous to them, but the people who were potential leaders. For instance, there were 12 licensed doctors of Italian descent in Canada. 10 were arrested. Doctors. Anyway, it's very, I just felt very angry when the project was abandoned. I said, how would it? I'll do a play, and it's going to go up in April and of next year.
Vittorio, I thank you. It was an honor and a privilege to have you with us, and I hope you can join us in the future.
Thank you very much.